guys, and we look forward to being with you guys, and we hope you have a good time. And I want to thank my dad for agreeing to for offering to host tonight. We really appreciate that. So bring some wine, have some food.
Well, there aren't really any groomsmen. I am performing the wedding. I am actually the clergy today.
Let's get a request of this.
Yeah.
See how official this is. Okay.
Universal Life Church. So yeah, and I think that, I don't know if there's even officially sort of a bridal party. I think they're more of just like, you know, Lisa has a maid of honor. But like the only person staying next to Jack is going to be his sister. It's more of like a family representation instead of a bridal party, which is kind of what this whole thing is about. It's about family. So yeah.
Any words to Lisa?
You know, I don't know. Keep it in the road.
We're getting ready.
Welcome to Lisa's wedding.
She's about to get married.
What I want to say is that these two women are really important to me. They're my best friends, and they're really smart, amazing, beautiful, awesome people.
Jack's also
on.
She's doing entire shots.
Can you get it, sir? It's that black box right there.
So I actually moved him because of the...
You're good.
Did you see it?
I didn't. I couldn't really. I like saw you, but I didn't. There's so many people around. I didn't like.
What do you think?
Very. That was very good.
Was it much more expected?
I didn't know what to do. To be honest, I enjoyed it. Would it be like hello? Would it be?
Like I'm gonna mark this now that you think it's yours.
Lisa, Jack, talk to me here. Tell me about today. This is a video here.
Well, today's our wedding day.
I've been at my dad's.
How'd it go?
What
was it like? What'd you do?
It was good. We just hung out a little bit, and David and Joe came over.
Oh, good.
Had a beer.
Oh, good.
And my mom brought me a sandwich.
Aww.
Because I realized I forgot breakfast and lunch. They put an English muffin in the toaster oven and then
Aerinate it.
Walked away.
Aerinate it.
Okay, good.
She was like, someone left this in the toaster. I don't know who it was, but I'm gonna eat it.
Then as soon as I got there, I was like, shit, I'm hungry. Oh, I forgot to eat.
I hope you don't mind. I read it to Aaron and Sarah and Katie.
Yeah.
And Katie and Sarah both cried.
Oh. Yes.
And I also, now I'm really nervous about my vows.
What?
Because I didn't know you said this.
That's just the warm up.
I have lipstick.
Oh, I see your blonde. Well, that's pretty.
And baby, this is the color that I wanted my dress to be.
I know.
Couldn't find a dress.
Did you? Is that Forrest in that? Or
yeah, the Forrest.
The hair
person did it, but the Forrest brought them.
Exactly. And I'm gonna have Jack. You're gonna pull Lisa in for.
Go for it.
Okay.
I feel a raindrop, so we're gonna go to that tree area.
Did George drive you over?
Yeah.
Did you send him back to your family?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Which I hope it worked out because they were like, no.
So I'm gonna have you kind of kind of cheat your left arm down a little bit. Yeah, exactly. Yep. Paparazzi following us.
Everywhere you go.
Actually, kind of glance over. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, you can look at me. There we go.
Can you try calling Honey and see if she'll come toward you? So just make sure you place your feet carefully because it is slippery.
Okay.
Sometimes.
Okay.
I'm just being paranoid.
That would be something I can remember.
I don't think your family's gonna like it if I like cause you to.
I think
Hey guys. You bet.
You saved your life.
Way to go.
But look at the kids before they change.
Where are they?
Get them to me.
Where did Lori
go? Oh my God. Adam and Madam.
How are you?
You guys look amazing.
You don't see them at all?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I have an actual
for catching up
with that.
Hey,
yeah,
I love your tie.
We have
it
more often.
It's a one that goes along the neck.
It's a real tie?
Yeah. Wow. I'm loving it.
Maddie
was
the
tie.
So good.
You look really good. And I love your shoulder pad.
Maddie,
yes.
I think she was in the
No, she was.
Oh,
well,
that'd be great.
Maybe you said to me they're going to take your clothes off.
You don't, you can't.
Yeah, I have no
safety.
I'm
here.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll just tell them, everything is in that fridge right there. That's only drink stuff. Right here, that black fridge.
Places the beer out.
So you have one CO2 can that's going
yeah.
up.
Yeah, just keep it simple.
Hello! You should all just go. Hello!
Hi!
Anything you want to say to Lisa and Jack?
Congratulations!
Congratulations! Everything looks beautiful.
What do you mean? I have a microphone on. Did you get mic'd? Well, hey buddy, I saw you in your hospital room.
It's a lot different now.
He's so blonde and blue, huh?
Well, that's what I was like.
A little Aryan baby.
I forget which one it is.
I don't know either. You guys okay if we turn this light off?
Thank you.
Yes, you may want to claim this spot right here.
Yeah, this is cooler.
Yes.
Oh, this is interesting.
Yeah.
That room there is the
kitchen.
Yeah, grass here, the one down by the pond. It's all part of the same property.
So you've come here for Thanksgiving quite a bit.
I've been here for Thanksgiving, Christmas, 4th of July, New Year's, at different times.
So there's a lot of snow here.
There is. Last time we were here, this past winter, I couldn't get up the... I go on that side, right? Do we have the rings?
Katie has
both. Mine too? Do they really? Do they have them?
I don't know. Yeah, okay.
Both? Mine too? Okay. All right, here we go. She's picking him up.
I know some of you traveled very far to be here today, and I speak on behalf of Jack and Lisa when I thank you for your presence and your support. So, we are here today to celebrate a confirmation and deepening of love. Now, I know some of you may feel that Jack and Lisa are rushing into this. Having only dated a brief 13 years. But truthfully, today is not just about taking a step forward. It's also about celebrating steps already taken. Jack and Lisa have already dedicated their lives to one another. they've already been through a great deal together. They've conquered long periods of time when, due to jobs or school, there's been a great distance between them. And while this distance was challenging, it also gave them the space to pursue their own careers and passions and allowed them to rededicate their love to one another by knowing, by desiring, to still remain together even though they were apart. Now, it is said that absence sharpens love and presence strengthens love. And I cannot think of a stronger, sharper, more battle-tested love than Jack and Lisa. And as Lisa's brother, I've had this like great opportunity to watch their love grow. I was actually the first person in my family to meet Jack. I went to Northwestern to help Lisa move, and I came home, and my dad asked me what he was like, and I said, he's just like Lisa. because that's true, they are similar, but that's not the whole story.
She's cuter.
Yeah. It is more than that, though. It's more than just like similarities. They complement each other. They complete each other. They magnify in each other all of their wonderful qualities. I mean, Jack and Lisa have found their soulmates, their counterparts. And we, as their friends and family, are all a part of that love and their story. And that's one of the reasons that they wanted to do this, to gather everyone together here today under one roof and celebrate their love. And there could not be a better place to do it. This property was bought by my grandfather in the 70s and turned from a horse stable into a home. Then in 1995, literally right here on this spot, my parents got remarried, and about 15 years after that, literally right here on this spot, my brother-in-law Jason proposed to my sister Erin. So there could not be a better place in all the world to celebrate love once again. Absolutely. Now, when my parents got remarried here, in remembrance of that day and to celebrate that, my grandfather planted a tree outside. It's that very large pine tree in the backyard. And to follow that tradition, Jack and Lisa, with the help of Paige and Claire, who are up there, also planted a tree outside, not only in remembrance of this day, but also in remembrance of my father, Andy, our father, I should say, Andy. and now I believe Jack and Lisa have written their own vows.
Yes. Now I get to go first. Okay. Jack. I feel like I've always known you. Even the very first time that we met, when we watched the Chappelle Show.
Good show.
And, good show. And we laughed at all the same parts.
Yeah.
It felt like we already knew each other. And I think that's because, you know, we really like saw each other. There was some way that we were able to do that. I felt comfortable and open with you right away. And I think that's because you kind of created this space for me to just like be myself. I feel more like myself when I'm with you. I feel relaxed and happy. And I think that there's something kind of, you know, sort of magic or chemical when people find that kind of connection, but not everybody is lucky enough to find it with such a wonderful person. Because I don't just admire you. I don't just love you. I also really, really admire you. And one of the things that I admire about you is that you really know yourself. You really know your strengths and your weaknesses. And Yeah,
yeah. He does.
Yeah. And you're very secure in who you are. You have this really sort of perfect and very attractive balance between confidence and modesty. You may be the only person that I have never ever heard exaggerate or tell a little white lie. Seriously, like I can't think of any other person that I've never heard do this in 13 years. And I've seen you in a lot of situations to try to impress someone. You just are who you are, and people respond however they respond, and you're totally comfortable with that. And you know, you're no bullshit. And this is not just a really sexy quality. It's also really brave, and it's really rare, and it makes you very trustworthy. You have more integrity than I think anyone I've ever known, and I'm just really constantly in awe of it. You show up for the tough things. You're the person who I would want with me when any shit goes down. And you're actually, you know, you're the person I always want with me, no matter what's happening. In addition to all of this, you're incredibly intuitive and you're empathetic. Like, you really see people and you see things even when it seems like you're not really paying attention. You pick up on all these little details, and you've taught me so much about how to love another person without any pride or selfishness. And it's really inspired me to be better. I feel like being around you makes me better. Maybe most importantly, you're funny as hell. And you still surprise me with your sense of humor. You know, like, it just comes out of nowhere, and it makes me laugh in this way that's like, it's like I'm falling in love with you again in that moment. And you do it all the time. It's like every day. I think it's one of the reasons I've stuck around for 13 years. I'm so grateful that I get to know you. Goofy, smart, loving, sensitive, courageous Jack. I've been forever changed by knowing and loving you. And I want to live our lives together bravely, like you are, to do it our way, and to have as much fun as we can.
Thank you. Love you. Okay. My book's a little smaller. Lisa, when we first met, you felt familiar. It was easy to talk to you and be with you, like I could tell who you were and that you got me, like there was something at our cores which was similar and connected. I'm not sure if I believe in fate, but I'm thankful that the chaos of the universe brought us together. I know that getting married gave you some pause for a while. Because it can lead to giving up one's identity in some senses. But I want you to know that in my eyes, that's not what we're doing. In my mind, we remain who we are as individuals. We maintain our individual identities, passions, and aspirations. But we reaffirm and announce our commitment to being equal partners. And as my partner, I have great respect for you. I could tell from first meeting you and still believe you are a person of real substance. You're thoughtful, introspective, truly caring of other people. I admire how you have and continue to make sacrifices to be there for your family. I love that you're smarter than me. And constantly challenge me. Your passion as an artist inspires me. you got me to like dogs. I know where she is. You made me realize the subtle and not so subtle ways that the world is still very sexist. You are a formidable woman. You make me laugh and sometimes cry. I have fun with you. You are a beautiful woman. For these reasons and many more, I love you and I'm excited to be your partner. We're not the same people today that we were 13 years ago when we met. And we won't be the same 13 years from now, but I commit to being there for you regardless of what changes inevitably come our way. I promise to bring humility to this marriage. I will understand that you will need me at times. And there will be times when I rely on you. I will remind myself that neither of us is perfect, but that we have strength together. That deep in our cores, I feel that we are connected. And that connection will allow us to make it through the tough times and the many more great, wonderful, and beautiful times we'll have together from this day forward. I love you.
All right, may I have the rings? Thank you. Oh, I need the other one too. Okay. Yes.
Going above and beyond.
Great job. Yeah. Great job, buddy. You can go back. You can go back to your desk. Great job. Please place these rings on each other's fingers as a symbol of your ever-present love for one another.
It's small.
I'm sweaty. Yeah.
Altitude. Lisa.
Yes.
Do you take Jack to be your partner in love and life?
I do.
Jack, do you take Lisa to be your partner in love and life?
I do.
I now pronounce you married.
Your vows were. Was I okay?
Okay.
Your vows were so good, baby. Oh my god. They were so good.
Hey, sister.
Hey, sister.
Good job.
Hey, thanks.
That was great, man.
That was really beautiful.
That was so good.
Couldn't keep it together.
Dude, no one can.
Congratulations, you're awesome.
Really, really good to see you. Nice to experience that with you.
Yeah.
How's you? You guys may at least die back there crying. Good.
That is the point. Oh. You'll make us cry in a couple months.
I'm sorry.
Say that hand.
Say what?
Hand to the surgeon.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Jack.
Thank you.
That was great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Joe.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good job.
What are these? Oh, this is the hors d'oeuvres.
You guys, we're gonna go sign our marriage contract.
Enclosed, please.
Cheers to Lisa and Jack.
Is that video or is it?
It's video.
Oh, so cheers.
You got it coming. Come on. So three, so make sure you're looking here.
Save a bittersweet pain and landed. You won't believe all that mattered. And under the sea, there'll never be another one like me. It was only an hour or so, I think, to sing a song. The sweetie painted lady, I could say I can feel, yeah, all of the matter, and never the sea.
Lisa and Sam and our mom Vicky, that we could have this wedding here today after a hard year. My father passed away in January, and I know that it would just mean so much to him that Lisa and Jack were getting married here today. This was his house, his home, his absolute favorite place. It would have meant so much to him. And I was trying to think of some advice he might give you guys today. And really, the best thing I could think of was what he told us a lot. It was just in starting your life as a married couple to try to just enjoy more and worry less. And I know at my wedding, it's too late for you guys now because you already said I do. But at my wedding, right before I walked down the aisle, my father leaned over to me and whispered, because we were about to walk out. He said, "Are you sure you want to do this? It's not too late. We can get out of here right now. Let's just jump in a cab, you and me." I know if he was here, he would have said the same thing to you. He would have gone for it too. And, oh yeah, Lisa and Jack. When Lisa asked me to speak today, I asked her if there's anything she did not want me to say, and she was really cool about it. She said, "No, just say whatever, but you know, I would rather you didn't say how long we've been together." And I was like, "Yeah, sure, no problem." But then I started thinking about it, and it's really the only thing I wanted to talk about was how long we've been together. Because they have been together a really long time. They started dating when Lisa was 19, and she just turned 33. So if you think about, not to call it your age, sorry. But if you think about not just the amount of years they've been together, but the life changes between 19 and 33, the fact that they've stayed together that long, it's really a testament to their love for each other. I already consider Jack family. I think it was their third round of long distance dating. I realized he wasn't going anywhere. That's when I started calling him in the middle of the night with my medical questions. So. And my husband and I, when we were in California, we were teasing Lisa and Jack that now that they're getting married, they have to start over from zero. And all their anniversaries start from one. They were very against this idea. But of course they were right. They're not starting from one. They have a more solid foundation going into marriage than any couple I know. And they do. And it's really in their spirit of thinking that this wedding today feels more to me like a celebration of an already very successful relationship than it does the beginning of something new. So I just wanted to say congratulations on your already lovely union and many more years to come.
Will be a great husband and dad, hopefully someday soon. He's inventive, adventurous, caring, and loving. He's great at just about everything, and he was a perfect big brother. Of course, there was the terrors inside, you know, where you shoved me in my closet and kept saying, "Freddy Krueger, Freddy Krueger," because it scared me to death. Or when you took the covers off my bed to wake me up in the morning, because I didn't want to get out of bed. But I'd like to believe you did those things because there was a persona to live up to. You had to do those big brother things because all big brothers do that, right?
I think so.
Not mine.
But deep down, you were the loving big brother type. For example, this memory stood out to me. I think it was the year I found out that our parents were Santa Claus, or maybe the year before.
Dang.
You did that?
When we developed that elaborate plan to trap Santa. Now I'm pretty sure you probably already knew, or maybe you just did that because you didn't want to ruin it for me. Also, you let me hang out with you and your friends from when we were in elementary school until high school, which made me feel cool and special. It's the things like that that made you such an awesome big brother. You're the reason why I started listening to Live 105. Why I wanted to try skateboarding. Why I like to dress more tomboyish. And why I have an adventurous and inventive side. I love you for all that and more. You've been with Lisa for 13 years, so you were basically already married in the eyes of the law. When I see you both together, you're both sweet and loving together, and I admire that. I think you're the perfect for one another, and now I'm so happy that it's official. I love you both.
Thanks.
I'm so happy for this day. Just look at these two, how beautiful they are. We waited a long, long time for this day to happen. And finally, I can call Lisa my daughter, daughter-in-law. And I love you. I'd like to first thank Vicky and the Rogel family for providing their home for this beautiful wedding. And I would also like to thank everyone for attending. I know most of you had to travel many miles to get here. And a special thanks to my mother, Angela, for who finally got on a plane from Los Angeles to see her grandson and Lisa get married. Now, Mom, you have no more excuses not to visit me in San Francisco. The first time I met Lisa was at Jack's graduation in Northwestern.
Really?
Yeah. I somehow had a feeling that Lisa would be the one that Jack would someday marry. She just seemed so special, so smart, so confident, and so beautiful. When they both graduated from Northwestern, Lisa went east and Jack went west. They were separated by 3,000 miles, or maybe more, I don't know. But their love for each other was so strong that somehow they made a bi-coastal relationship work. In fact, their relationship got stronger. The way they interacted was always so amazingly positive and beautiful. When Lisa and Honey finally moved to California, and Honey was always the most bi-coastal dog ever. I had the opportunity to spend more time with the two of them. Oftentimes we would meet in the Delta in Sacramento and we'd water ski. I can remember the first time that Lisa got behind that boat. Jack would give her the instructions, and Lisa was so determined to get up on that wakeboard, and it was so neat to watch how you took those instructions and you were just gonna get up no matter what, and you finally did. Jack showed so much patience through all of that. You could tell they made a great team from that point. Now about Jack. As you all know, Jack is a very special guy, smart, kind, and talented in many ways. I can remember when he was 1.5 years old, he had this fascination with vacuum cleaners. He'd go around the house saying, vacuum, vacuum, vacuum. He made sure we had the cleanest house in the neighborhood. I also remember working in the garage and in the yard with Jack on my back, the backpack. He was always so fascinated, showed so much interest in tools, especially hammers. That's when I knew someday he would either be a carpenter or maybe a surgeon. Well, I'm sure he could probably build a pretty good house, as you saw at that beer bar. But thankfully, he became that surgeon, and he's rebuilding jaws instead. However, I do want to present Jack with his first special tool that started it all. His hammer. His hammer.
This is the actual hammer.
That's the actual hammer
that you made me.
Jack, yeah. Wow. I would now like everyone to join me in a toast, wishing Jack and Lisa all the happiness that life has to offer, along with a fulfillment of all their dreams, and hopefully someday creating some cousins for Adam, Madeline,
yes,
and Eve.
Hello all. I have not met a lot of you, and I'm sorry about that. I'm Jim Rogal, Lisa's uncle, Andy's brother. On behalf of everybody, and as others have done, I want to welcome you, but I want you to know I'm welcoming you to a Rogal family home, Vicky's home, Andy's home. And that has a lot of meaning to the Rogals. So I hope to all of you. It breaks my heart that Andy isn't here. I know how he'd feel. Maybe more than any of you, I know how he'd feel. And he would just be bursting. So I'm gonna be real brief. I don't have any stories other than to tell you I was there. You talked about when you first met Lisa, when you first met Jack. I first met Lisa the day she was born. She was already beautiful and tough. And I mean that in the best way. Vicky is tough. Andy was tough. In the best way, in the way that you all know tough to be a good thing. It means show up for each other. And what I want to commit to both of you, and what I'd ask all of you to commit to Lisa and Jack today, is to be there for you anytime you need it. You got that from me, and I assume from everybody else in this room. Congratulations.
To make an egg sandwich together? Because you will never hear an egg sandwich more minutely broken down. We had breakfast together once. This was at our old home in Richmond. It took them an hour and a half to make two egg sandwiches. I'm not even, should we do shredded cheese? The benefits of shredded cheese are that it gets in the nooks and crannies, but a slice of cheese is more coverage. Well, okay, are we doing scrambled eggs or fried eggs? Well, if we do an English muffin, there's more nooks and crannies. It was literally an hour and a half. But I do want to talk about Jack a little bit, because this would normally be the time we would welcome Jack to the family, but as has been said many times tonight, Jack is already very much a part of our family. Jack taught me how to shotgun beers in high school. Sorry. But
where did you learn how to shotgun a beer?
With surgical precision.
Jack hasn't just been there for the fun times with us. He's also been there through all of our difficult times, literally at our parents' bedsides for different hospitalizations, always on the other end of a phone with invaluable advice and guidance that helped us get through these really difficult decisions that we had to make, because we knew it was coming from somebody who cared, who had an emotional stake in what was going on. And as been said, you know, my father isn't here today, but
he's here.
I know that he liked Jack, he loved Jack, he cared about Jack, he saw in Jack all the qualities that he revered in other people, like grit and heart and strength and knowing when to be caring and when to be strong. And you know,
Lisa and Aaron and I have always depended a lot on each other. There have been many hard times when we've said, thank God there's three of us. And I know that without Lisa to lean on, that I wouldn't be the person that I am today. And I know that she has found someone perfect for her, and always knew that, and Dad knew that. And so, Jack, I don't want to welcome you to the family, but I want to thank you for already having been such an amazing part of it. Thank you, Jack.
Yeah. In the womb. He was an accountant.
Pulled.
Pulled.
TMI.
Minutes later, the charge nurse said, please, please take your son. He is creating such a ruckus. And all the babies are just, they can't calm down. They're screaming. I said, thinking to myself, isn't he a baby too? Well, I gladly took my 9-pound baby with the banana-shaped head. And there was something more, but I loved him dearly, like we all do. Justine soon arrived, and the prince was deposed, proclaiming he was going to kill her. Blue eyes blazing, you know that one. I said, if you do, you'll go to jail. And he was, I could see his head and mind working. Gosh. Well, what's it like crying? I said, it's a horrible place. You'll never see your mom and dad again. And he goes, So Justine's nickname was Kid Dynamite or Whack-a-mole.
Whack-a-mole?
Whack-a-mole. You know, like, knock her down, she comes back up.
Whack-a-mole.
Yeah. Nice. Fast forward to his tenacity in school, college, sports, music, everything beautiful. He's, like I said before, never gave me a day of trouble except for those early years. I believe he looked at his parents and said, these people are crazy. I'm going to forge my own path. Lovely Lisa entered his life, and ever since, I should throw these down, ever since that, I saw a softening. And they do have an eternal love, a glow about them, a give and take, and the kind of relationship everyone longs for. Aww. I think they're right.
Okay. So, kind of wrap things up here, and for the speeches, I know this has been a long. I may go off script a little bit because I think a lot of what I was going to say has been said, and you know, just in general, we're so happy that everyone was able to get together, and I know this is not an easy place to get to. We have people coming from California and New York and all over the place, and it's just really nice having everyone together. This is what we hope for, just kind of having everyone together and just spending time together, and it's really nice. I wanted to say thank you to my family, to my parents and my sister for always being supportive of our relationship and for being here today. And as was said earlier, Nana, almost 90 years old, got on a plane and came all the way here. And if we could have had your food for dinner, we would have.
In our this is our VIP.
Lisa is the biggest fan of your
food. I love you.
She'll cook for you when you come to California.
And thank you to Lisa's family, and in particular to Vicky. Thank you for letting us use your home. It's been beautiful. And thank you for being such a strong and optimistic person.
And Kate.
So inspiring.
Thank you.
Thank you to Vicky's nurses and Keith and Michelle for all the work you guys did this week getting the house in shape.
Yeah.
Although it's raining today, it's been like 95 degrees and sunny every day this past week, and all these people were outside sweating, mowing the lawn, digging holes,
unclogging the septic system.
Thank you.
As has been said, you know, there's one person that's very clearly, obviously missing today, and that's Lisa's dad, Andy. You know, he was a pretty amazing person, I'm sad that my family never got to meet him. You know, he was the kind of guy who let you know how he felt about you, and if he respected you, he was very generous and complimentary, but it never felt forced or fake. He was a true people person, and seemed to always get to the true heart of what someone was about, no matter who they were or what their background was. It didn't matter. He would have played a big role tonight. And I'm sad he's not here, but I'm thankful for the amazing job he did raising Lisa. And I see many of his good qualities in you. And to Lisa, you look beautiful tonight. I've loved you for a long time, and I love you now more than ever. I'm excited and honored to be your husband. Let's all continue to have a great time tonight. Enjoy the food, enjoy the alcohol, there's plenty of it. Don't let the rain bother you. Go outside and dance, come back in and dance. And let's all raise a glass. Cheers to family, to good friends, and most importantly to Lisa.
Have been sitting through a lot, but some of you may know that I've been working on a wedding gift for Jack. And many of you here participated in that gift, and now you get to see the fruit of your labor. I'm supposed to vamp, but I'm not that good at it, because we have a little setup that has to happen for this gift. You sit right there. So my gift to Jack was that Jack is a very modest person, and he's a very unassuming person, and sometimes that results in not always getting to, hear everything that's so amazing about him. And so I asked everyone that loves Jack to say something about him. And then I really, really amateurly edited this video. So please enjoy. I don't really know what I'm doing. So it may not be perfect, but
it's all good.
We'll all kind of watch
and see what happens.
The wine glass.
Aaron, hit those lights over there, the green ones.
The loud enough.
That was so beautiful, Lisa.
Oh,
It's a video.